I'm Dr. Keith Aljets from the Veterinary Medical Center and VMC Management in Williamsburg, Iowa. We've worked with Choice Genetics for off and on for probably the past 15 or 20 years, but this is by far the closest that we've worked with them on the Wolf Creek project. So far, our relationship has been very good. Choice had very healthy animals to stock the farm. They had the right number of gilts that we needed. The gilts arrived at the proper time. And so far, the animals have been tremendously productive. So Wolf Creek has been a very good project, and it's been a great project, I guess, when you look at the aspects that Choice has brought to the table for us. In regarding the ability of sows to have pigs, to come in gastrus, and our wean average has been above target from what we thought for Wolf Creek. Well, one of the reasons that Wolf Creek has been successful so far has been the health of the animals. First off, the animals came in very healthy. We've had no issues with any of the known viruses that pigs routinely harbor. And the animals that we've continued to purchase from Choice have been very healthy. And therefore, the pigs that we're weaning have been very healthy and have performed tremendously post-weaning. Why did we choose Maximus? You know, we knew we wanted to do an ESF system at Wolf Creek. And we had done some other ESF systems, and we wanted to choose a system that it was more easy to train gilts with. And we looked at the Maximus system, and we felt like our gilt training would be improved with that system. We also felt like, or we knew we were going to use Maximus for a ventilation system, and then combining the use of the technological equipment for the ESF, and then for our record system, and then for the ventilation system, made choosing, or just all helped us decide to use the ESF system for Maximus. You know, I almost think it's performed better than we expected. Certainly we have animals that need to be trained, but I think the farm feels like our training has been easy to handle. The animals will become trained, and the percentage of animals that we're training isn't as high as maybe what we would have predicted. So, especially going through startup where you've got, you know, all the animals to train over a 5-month period versus the normal gilt replacement where we just have, you know, 20% of your animals that you need to train on a group basis. So, overall, we've been very pleased with the training aspects, and really don't do that much for training in regarding the ESF system with Maximus. The animals pretty much train themselves and pretty much depends, and there's a few that we have to run back through the system, but by and large they learn the system and away they go. What have I learned about group housing systems? I think one of the most interesting aspects of the Maximus ESF system is that when we designed our pens, it was pretty important to have bedding areas, dining areas, feeding and watering areas in those pens. And now when I walk out in the gestation barn and I look through the pens, I can see where the sows are laying down in the bedding areas. They're dining in the dining areas, and they're eating and drinking in the eating and drinking areas. And it's just, the sows are just extremely comfortable. Some of that, I think, is the sow that we've chosen, but it also is a system that was designed by us from Maximus. Gilts, certainly one of the biggest concerns when we decided to do ESF was gilts and gilt training. And with the Maximus system, the gilt training has been pretty simple. We've installed panels on our feeders in acclimation, so when the gilt eats, she has to learn to back up. We've reinforced that behavior in our acclimation pens in the gestation barn, or heat checking pens in the gestation barn. Again, the gilt eats and she backs up. That little bit of training trains her so that when she gets into the gestation pens and she's pregnant and she uses the electronic sow feeder for the first time, that she learns to go in and eat and she has to back up. That system has worked fairly well for us here at Wolf Creek. How have our staff members adapted to the new technologies from Maximus? Well, I think that It's certainly been a learning curve. Most of the people that work here at Wolf Creek are young. Certainly the younger people are more technologically advanced than what some of us older folks are. But they can, they can use a scanner, find a sow, and look her up immediately on Maximus. They can look at their records, which are real-time data entry, and see exactly where we're at a farm. They can go over to the controller, and we can run through the different rooms and say adjust the heat mat settings to different settings in all the rooms in just a few minutes. We can check the positive pressure, the pressure in our attic, pressure in the rooms. There's so many things we can do so quickly with the technology that we have available through Maximus that we're certainly glad that we've got that on this farm. How has our production been with the ESF penning system versus stalls? And while there's really no good way to answer that or to tell, it would be difficult to imagine that our production's been a lot better. The sows have performed very well with high live borns and weans that have exceeded our target. So I think our production is really maximized with the system that we have, and I can't see that it would be that much better from a stall building. How comfortable am I that sows are being fed properly every day? Well, we know sows are being fed properly every day because we just have to look it up on the system and it'll tell us the sows that aren't eating every day. I also know, when I walk out in the gestation pen and there's sows that are 4 or 5 days away from farrowing, I can go through that pen and I can see that the body condition of all the sows is about the same. How confident am I that every sow is being fed properly every day? Well, I'm very confident. For one, we can look at a list of sows that choose not to eat for a day. Then we can go on those pens and determine whether there's something wrong with the sow or not. Typically, there isn't. But we also can look at sows that are pre-farrow. And when I walk through those pens, I'm pretty amazed to see how good and how uniform the body condition is on a sow, on sows that have been in pens and been fed through the Maximus system. By and large, if we do a good job of adjusting the feed curves on sows, the sows all look, probably 85% of the sows are all the same body condition, which I think we've been able to do a better job with this system than we have done in some of our stall buildings. Service training and support for Maximus. Overall, I think it's gone very well. Wolf Creek is a fairly big project. With big project, there's no big projects, there's no doubt that from time to time you have problems and issues. And I think every one of the issues that we've had has been addressed probably above and beyond the call of duty. From our standpoint, Maximus has really done a good job helping us through any issues that we've had done. They've been a good job with training regarding the ESF system and ventilation system. And I feel like they're very accessible for us if we have questions in the future. You know, I think that as a whole, pig farms have not been, have not utilized technology as fast as other industries have. So I'm certainly excited to see that with Maximus we can use the same vendor for ventilation and for records and for the ESF system. One of the parts I like the most about it is the data is accessible in real time from the record standpoint. The data is, from the ventilation standpoint, the data is accessible on my cell phone or on my desktop computer in my office. And I know the farm uses their phones not only to access data, but to check ventilation. And all that technology, and I think we have a lot of technology advances that we can continue to make in this industry, but we've been happy so far with the three-part system that we utilize for Maximus. Well, the big advantage for me is that when I want to look up real quickly and see how breeds are going at Wolf Creek Pork, I can look it up on a Wednesday and I've got breeds entered through Wednesday. If I want to see how many pigs they weaned, the data's there. So just having that data accessible is convenient. and we're in a convenient world. You know, we've got data available on our fingertips from a lot of other sources, so there's no reason to not have that data available from the pig farm.